Okay, I really wish he weren't flipped. I'm gonna move him. This is his arc of fire. He's gonna move into here next door. Take a check on a one. Pulls a four. See what he can do. Maybe we can flush this guy out. Let's see what happens down here. I'm waiting for this guy to move. I hope this guy moves. Command order. No short range business, thank you. No one's rallying. Highest firepower AI, farthest from a hit unit fire. Well, we're still one, two, three. He's night rules, he doesn't see this guy, so that's not gonna happen. Under normal rules, that would happen. AI in a zero DM hex closest to a target, low risk move towards cover closest to the target. All right, this is why you're watching a video, to watch me struggle with these kinds of commands. All right, the AI, who is in a zero DM hex closest to a target, is clearly this guy, okay? Now, he would like to low risk move, not necessarily towards the target, but towards cover that is closest to the target. And this is a command card, so he won't be making a check. All right, so wow. This will probably generate some comments, because I'm sure they're, let's see if I do this correctly here. Closest to a target. This guy, this is his closest target, not him. So we have to base everything off him. And the cover that's closest to this guy is what, this? Or this? I mean, this cover is one away from this guy. I mean, if you ask me, the cover that is literally closest to the target is this. It's next door to him. That's the closest cover. This is two away. But he can't low risk move towards this because he's not going to move into either one of these, right? So maybe this is also two away from him and this is two away. So again, it's the cover that's closest to the target, not the cover that's closest to him. Don't read the card as that, right? It's the cover that's closest to the target. So this is one away, this is two away, this is two away. So he can low risk move into here. If he backs up, it's a backup move, but he's moving. Can he do that? That is still a fire zone hex. So if he's in a fire zone hex, he will move into a fire zone hex that has the same or higher defensive modifier. Well, that's a zero, that's a zero. And he will move towards the target's flank. So I think he's going to get a little bit closer to cover. He can't get close to this one, but he can get closer to this one. So that's how I'm playing it. Feel free to tell me that that's wrong or you would play it a different way. But since he can't low risk move into one of these to get closer to this, he can low risk move to his second option for cover closest to target. So that's going to be a check on a, well, it's not a check because it's a command order, so there's no check. It would be a check on a two. Okay. All right, so he did that. So I'm going to continue this gambit. wait a minute. As soon as he moves down here, this guy can see him. Right. And he'd be firing a 3 to a 12. Yeah, you know what? I might do that. I might do that. Is that crazy? This is great. This is a fun scenario. I'm honestly not sure what to do. I don't feel like shooting a 4 to a 13. I just don't feel like doing that. I'm hoping that he will crazy Ivan it and move towards me and I'll get a shot, a short range shot. This guy's flipped, so I'm gonna have to cap move him. I'm gonna cap move him over here. And start doing something over here. I'm not exactly sure what. All right, nothing up top. No short range business. Counteractions, I didn't pass, and I didn't fire, so skip that. All right, do any fresh units have a shot? No, he's one, two, three away still. Oh, he does. He does. AI farthest. Well, he's the only guy that has a shot. So AI farthest from the lowest defensive unit. Fire. But he won't fire because he's rolling a 3 to a 14. He needs an 11. He won't do that. So what does that mean? So no one's going to shoot. The largest group of AIs closest to, skip my subject, to a unit, low risk move towards. The largest group. Right now, everything's a group of one. The largest group closest to a unit. Isn't that him? Could be an RE, but I don't see any RE who's as close as this guy. So now he is going to low risk move towards. And now here's where we have another... we have another case of 5.2. If he can't move in a way that will decrease the hexes, he can move in a way that will improve his position, such as moving into cover or moving into flank. And this satisfies both of those. Well, see, now I lost my shot by doing that. Whatever. So he is going to, that's in his front arc. He's going to move into here and face this way. And now, not that it matters for the Pioneer's flank, but he's in my flank. I can't shoot him. See, now he can do this, and now I got troubles. And that's what the AI is doing here. Son of a gun. Son of a gun. Let's see if he flips. I think that's what's going to happen. He's gonna low-risk move over to there. He pulls a 2. And that was a 2 because it was the plus 1 for that. All right, so that helps. Oh, boy. Maybe we get the hell out of Dodge. 1, 2, 3. How about we move here like this? We'll stay in this facing. And that's a 1. And I'm playing with this. Still, why not? But it was a 4 anyway. Okay, back to them. Aha! Place an RE, see the special rules. Okay, so on the map, there are these yellow positions. Doop, 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 doop. So I simply am gonna roll a die and put an RE marker on the corresponding position. Number 1 is way up here. I'm okay with that. And then I need to put a no enemy into the cup, right? Because there should always be an equal number of REs on the board and then chits in the cup, so that when you pull, you always have an even number. So that happened. No short range business. Counteractions don't apply because I didn't pass and I didn't fire. No fresh unit has a shot, so I can skip fire. Unhit AI, closest to a unit in a 0 DM hex move towards. Well, this is just crazy. I think it's this guy. So an unhit AI, closest to a unit in a 0 DM hex. They're all. So this guy's 1, 2, 3, 4. This guy's 1, 2, 3, 4. This guy's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This guy's 1, 2, 3. This guy's 1, 2, 3, 4. This guy's 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Unhit AI, closest to a unit in a 0 DM hex. 1, 2, 3, 4. Move towards. So he's going to leave cover. And that just seems really dumb. But, I mean, then again, sometimes they do dumb things. And it works out. I'm going to pause and make sure I'm doing this right. Yeah, I think that's correct. He's 3 away. Everyone else is 4 away. Takes a check on a 2. And he pulls a 5. Hey, we can see each other now. Hey, he's got a 3, I've got a 2, so, you know, maybe he knows what he's doing. I don't want to use this rapid deployment on this guy, but I could do a rapid deployment, to swing this guy down here for 2 hexes, and I got this guy to worry about. And I would be shooting, what, a 5 to a 10? I would cap it to a 7 to a 10? That's not bad. Either that or I cap move this guy here. Cap move. Does Cap moving this guy here do anything for me? If he's here, I don't know that it does anything for me. If this guy's going to shoot, he's going to shoot at him because he's easier to hit. He would be a 12. This guy would be a 13. And then he's here. And then if I used rapid deployment on him, I could only get here, which doesn't really do me any good. Maybe I should just... If I rapid deploy, this guy could shoot him. And he could be firing at, you know, whatever, 3, 2, and 11. Or no, I would face him like this, so at least it would be in his front. So it would be a 3 to a 12. Oof, but then I got this guy. I think I'm going to do it. I think I'm talking myself into it. I mean, I could move him here, then move him here, and then swing them both down. All right. I talked myself into doing that. He's going to move. This guy better not do anything. He's going to move here. That's the thing. There's the opportunity. If I do this and this guy does this, I'm going to do it. I love the idea of getting this guy down. This guy with his five and eight, gets here, 8 to 10. I wouldn't even need to cap that. All right, that was a cap. So back to them. Hey, good old reshuffle the deck. No short range business, no counteractions. I did not pass, I did not fire. There's no hit AI. Highest firepower AI, farthest from a unit that just acted. This is the unit that just acted. And no one has a shot due to the knight, right? Under normal rules, this guy could shoot at him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This guy would actually, no, highest firepower, yeah, highest firepower AI from a unit that just acted. This guy is farthest from a unit just acted. If the flares happen, then we've got problems because then he can see them. But this is the unit that just acted. This command is only about the unit that just acted. So not going to happen, not going to fire plus 2 caps. AI farthest from a unit that just acted. We had this before. This is the unit that just acted. The AI farthest from him is going to low risk move towards. Whoops. I think that's going to be, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 9, 10. Or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 10, 11. This guy, low risk move towards. The AI, farthest from the unit that just acted. Low risk move towards. This is more towards his flank, so I'm gonna have him move up here. I gotta reshuffle the deck. And he takes a check on a 1 and he pulls a 6. Okay, I just realized it would be incredibly stupid if I were to move this guy into here. This guy could then get a shot on both of them. So I'm just gonna have to do this. I'm gonna use my rapid deployment. It costs 0. And he's gonna move around here. So he just moved. I keep him facing like this, so. Showing my front to this guy as well. And that's all that happens. Back to them. Nothing up top, no short range, no one's rallying. AI closest to the lowest fire. Again, this guy can't see him. 1, 2, 3. Okay, he can't fire at him. Holy crap, stuff's going to get crazy here in a second. So, no fresh unit has a shot. Skip. AI closest to a unit, closest to a mission objective. There are no mission objectives, so there is no unit closest to a mission objective. Skip. How about this? All RE. Everybody, it's a group move. Low risk move towards the closest units. Wow, that's kind of crazy. All RE, low risk move. I might just pause the camera to do this, because this is kind of crazy. And I gotta decide. All right, fine. I guess everyone will take a check individually. He goes there and takes a check on a one. He's fine. This guy, I think he could move into either one. He'll move here. It's a little more behind. Takes a check on a two. He's fine. This guy is going to go here. Take a check on a two. He's fine. All right, all RE, low risk move towards the closest unit. All right, this guy will move here. Take a check on a one. He's fine, it was a six. This guy will just move sideways. All right, that's all of them. Low risk move towards the closest unit. He's gonna move. Moving here would be more in the front. Moving here is slightly more to the flank of this guy. That's his closest unit. So he's gonna take a check on a one. Well, he flips at least. This guy is, conversely, he's gonna go this way. So he's gonna move here as opposed to here. And he pulls a six. This guy's simply gonna move into, he just moved into this building. Okay, takes a check on a two, he flips. This guy would prefer to move into cover, takes a check on a two and he flips. This guy prefers to move into cover because that's what they would rather do. Not within a fire zone, has the highest defensive modifiers. It would be the next, whoops, what am I doing? He pulls a four, so he doesn't flip. This guy down here, honestly, I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh no, this guy, he's closer to this guy. So this would be more in his front. This would be more to his flank, slightly. So we'll have move there on a one. And then lastly, this guy, low risk move. He won't low risk move. I don't think he can execute the command because he can't. He won't move into short range. He can't move off the board. Moving here doesn't do anything for him, so he does not execute the command. Okay, that was weird. All right, let's do it. We've got 2 plus 3 is 5. Why don't we throw our careful aiming in? So now we're at a 7. You have to do this before rolling the dice. So 7 to 10. And if I roll a 7, that's a 14. That's 4 more. So I say the odds are I'm going to roll a 7. So I'm going to go, I'm not going to cap it. I'm just going to use careful aiming. Oh, one shy. Oh, I should have thrown one cap in to be sure. Gosh darn it. 13 to 10. Gosh darn it, I should have thrown it. That was dumb. Whoops, whoa, don't drop this. I say it was dumb because this guy cost 3 to fire, so I should have gone all, I should have thrown 2 caps in. I should have gone all in because killing him right off the bat is what I wanted to do. I did not announce that I was capping this, so I just have to take this as a straight. Ooh, I got lucky there. All right. Cool. All right, back to them. If AI plus units is 4 or fewer, now we don't count RE in this equation, but still we are more than 4. What do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the record. All right, no short range business. Well, there is some short range business. He can't fire, but he can pivot. So we have to look at this to see if he's pinned. Ooh, he's suppressed. Okay, so he is going to pivot. I think this puts them both of these guys in his arc of fire. So he doesn't want to go all the way here. He just wants to stop here. He wants to pivot. And that costs 2. Yeah, and he flips. And he's only shooting with 1. All right, so now we're shooting at his 12. We're at a 5 to a 12. And I have the same thing as last time. Do I cap it twice and go to 7 to 12? Yes. Yes, 7 to 12. All right, so 2 plus 3 plus 2. 7. Okay. Wasted 2 caps. What are you going to do? Wanted to be sure. All right, but still, I'm not going to complain about that. We got this Maxim off the board. I need to take a check on a 3, and he's still... I think I badmouthed this guy earlier. He's MVP right now. And now my favorite part, removing a command card. That's the next command card. And my second favorite part, shuffling. He has this. He had it last time as well, but it didn't matter. I don't think it mattered. I hope it didn't matter. I'll check on the video, on the command. Yeah, this guy would have had a shot at him anyway, so it didn't matter whether or not he had that. This guy was in range. All right. So he shot, he didn't flip, took the Maxim out, got rid of a card. We don't get any VP for that, but clearing the path out, I like that. All right, let's go back to them, let's see what they do. Nothing up top, no short range business. Fresh AI, fewer than us, no, because RE do count in this case. They don't count up here, but they'll count down here because they're all AI. Here you go. Highest firepower AI from blah, 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 fire. This is the only guy who has a shot, so I don't even need to really figure anything out. He's going to fire plus 1 cap. So I'm going to reach into the cup. Now, again, if I pull out a German unit due to nighttime rules, he has to execute the order. Oh, that's the best thing I could have pulled. That's the best thing I could have pulled, so I don't suffer a shot. Hot damn. Okay. So in that case, that was the AI's turn. I don't keep going because I actually, you know, we went through with that with revealing a thing. So the action is completed, and we just got damn lucky. Now look at this. I got a wide open path to my prisoners down here. I got this guy to deal with, but otherwise I got a wide open path. Wow. Like I said, I'm glad I didn't video the practice run because I got wiped out. Then again, it's one thing to get here. It's another thing to get off the map. I've come down here and I've freed the guys and I got all these VPs and I'm all fat and happy. And then I tried to escape off the map and the Russians just pursued me and like somewhere... up in here, they just killed my guys. It was awful. It was a slaughter. Because I'm running away with my back towards them, and they kept catching up to me, and I kept thinking they would flip. They wouldn't flip, and they shot me in the flank. It was awful. Okay, so it's back to us, right? That was their attempted shot. And it's back to us. This guy still flipped, huh? Okay, 1, pulls a 5, is fine. Back to them. If AI plus units is 24 or fewer, absolutely it is. And so now, flares. Oh, snap. So now this guy can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He can see both of these guys. All right, bring it on. No short range business. Counteractions, the AI closest to a unit that fired, fire plus a cap, or move towards. Is this the guy that just fired? No, this, the muzzle flash should be gone now because the guy that just fired, it was this this guy, I'm sorry, this guy was the one that attempted to fire. So the muzzle flash should have been off here. So there is no unit that just fired. So for counteractions, AI closest to unit that fired, there is none. So I'm gonna go back to the card. No one needs to rally. Highest firepower AI closest to a hit unit fire. Well, here's the only hit unit. And he's the, is he the AI closest? Well, he's the highest firepower AI because all RE are considered to be lowest firepower. So he is the highest firepower AI closest to a hit unit. So he wants to fire at him. He's in his arc of fire. And he'd be rolling a 3 to a 13, and he'll roll that. 3 to a 13. He will roll, nope, I'm sorry, 3 to a 14. Remember, the front facing is on the bottom. So plus 12 plus 2 is 14, so 3 to 14, he will not roll that. So skip that. Highest firepower AI closest to a unit. Okay, now we're back to this guy firing at him, 3 to a 12. Again, because RE don't count, well, they have a lower firepower than this guy, so this guy has a shot on him. So he will roll a 3 to a 12. Come on, 7. 7! Yeah, there you go. Alright, so he missed, and he takes a check on a 4. Crap, that's a 6. And he gets the muzzle flash. Isn't he out in the open? All right, darkness falls over the board again. So, yeah, back to us. You know, I think I'm just gonna keep, like, get going while the getting's good, and this guy's gonna move into here for 1. Ah, crap. Come on, dude. You were doing so well. All right, back to them. Hey, got old reshuffled the deck. No short range. Counteractions don't apply because I didn't fire, I didn't pass. They don't need to rally. No fresh units have a shot because darkness has descended. Line of sight is 2. Mobile AI closest to a fresh unit that just acted. There is no fresh unit that just acted. There's a spent unit. Execute mission orders. All fresh RE with the symbol of the card, in this case, a white diamond, move 2 hexes towards... Ah, son of a bitch. So, this guy here is a white diamond, and he's a white diamond, but he's not fresh. This is fresh. This guy's going to move 2 hexes, 1, 2. He's like, hey, those prisoners need to be, you know, taken care of. So he's going to move over there, and then I have... And I have written over here, they make 1, 2 AP spent check. So I think that's correct. So he's gonna make a, and he pulls a 6. So he's fine.